What's up? Merde here, and in this video, we will be covering the deep muscles of the back. Generally, the muscles of the back consist of the superficial muscles and the deep muscles. Superficial muscles consist of the trapezius and the latissimus, which are the first layer. The second layer are the rhomboid major, minor, and the levator scapula. The third layer of muscles consists of the serratus posterior superior and inferior. And when you remove these three layers, you will finally get to the deep muscles at the back. Now, the deep muscles at the back are categorized based on their shape and structures and localization. Generally, they consist of the suboccipital muscles, there's a system of short muscles, the transversospinal system, the spinospinal system, and then there's a spinotransverse system. The suboccipital muscles consist of four muscles. These are the rectus capitis posterior major and minor, and there's the obliquus capitis superior and inferior. The system of short muscles consists of the interspinalis and the intertransversari muscles. The muscles you see in front of you now are considered the third layer of deep back muscles, meaning they're the deepest layer closest to the bone. Then we have the transversospinal system, which consists of the semispinalis, multifidi, and rotatoris. The rotatoris muscles consist of short and long muscle fibers. The short muscle fibers of rotatoris are considered a part of the third layer, since they are as close to the bones as the third layer are. The long fibers of rotatoris are considered a part of the second layer, as the multifidi and the semispinalis are. Next, we have the spinospinal system, which consists of spinalis, and the spinotransverse system, which consists of splenius, longissimus, and iliocostalis. All of these are considered as the first layer of the deep muscles of the back, or the most superficial ones, so these muscles are just below the superficial muscles of the back. Alright, even though the deep back muscles are divided into system of muscles, they all share the same features, and that is that 1. Almost all the deep back muscles originate and insert at the vertebra, and 2. All share the same function, which is extension of the vertebral column. So they provide stability of the vertebral column and they help maintain our posture and the natural curve of the spine. Let's now cover all of these muscles, starting with the third layer, which are closest to the bones. And we will start with these muscles you see here. So let's zoom in on them. The muscles you see here are called the suboccipital muscles since, well, they lie suboccipitally and they're therefore also considered as a system of deep muscles of the neck. Okay, first we have a muscle called the rectus capitis posterior minor, which originate at the posterior tubercle of the atlas and insert at the occipital bone below the inferior nuchal line. Then we have the rectus capitis posterior major, which originate from the spinous process of axis and insert at the inferior nuchal line of the occipital bone. So these are the rectus capitis posterior muscles. Then we have the oblique muscles of the head. The obliquus capitis superior, which originate at the transverse process of atlas and insert at the inferior nuchal line of the occipital bone, and the obliquus capitis inferior, which originate at the spinous process of axis and insert at the transverse process of atlas. So that was all the suboccipital muscles. Next, we have the muscles shown here between the vertebrae. They're called the system of short muscles. And the system of short muscles are a system connecting adjacent vertebrae together. And they consist of the interspinalis, which are here. The interspinalis are mostly developed in the cervical and the lumbar region, but they're also present in the thoracic region with less muscle fibers. The interspinalis are located between the spinous processes. They originate from the spinous process of the vertebrae below and insert at the spinous process of the vertebrae above. The other muscle is called intertransversari, which are here. They are mostly developed in the cervical region, and they lie between the transverse processes of the vertebrae. They originate from the transverse process of the vertebrae below, and insert at the transverse process of the vertebrae above. So that was the third layer of the deep back muscles. Now, let's see the second layer. Remember, they are the transversospinal system. The transversospinal system are a system of muscle fibers that go from the transverse process of the lower vertebrae to the spinous process of the upper vertebrae. It kind of makes sense when you look at the name. The first ones are the rotatoris muscles. The rotatorius muscles are deep muscles located in the thoracic region, and they consist of long and short fibers. The long rotatorius, which are here, originate from the transverse process of the vertebrae below and insert at the spinous process of two vertebrae above, so it skips one vertebrae. The short rotatorius muscles, however, these ones, are generally considered as a part of the third layer of deep back muscles, together with the suboccipital, interspinalis, and the intertransversari, as we looked at earlier. They originate at the transverse process of the vertebrae below and insert at the spinous process of one vertebrae above. So that's these ones. Then we have some slightly larger muscles called multifidi. The multifidi muscles fills the space lateral to the spinous process, and they're more distinctive at the lumbar region. The multifidi also consist of short and long fibers. The short multifidi muscles go like this. They originate at the transverse process of the vertebrae below and insert at the spinous process of two vertebrae above. The long multifidi muscles originate at the transverse process of the vertebrae below and insert at the spinous process of three vertebrae above. So that's generally how the multifidi muscles are arranged. Next, we have the semispinalis, which are here. They consist of three parts, so let's go through them. First, we have the semispinalis thoracis, which are here highlighted in green. They originate from the transverse process of T6 through T11 and insert at the spinous process of C6 to T4. Then there's the semispinalis cervicis, which is here in yellow. This one originates from the transverse process of T1 to T6 and insert at the spinous process of C2 to C5. And the last part is the semispinalis capitis, which is here in purple. This one originates from the transverse process of C4 to T6 and insert at the occipital bone between the inferior and the superior nuchal line. So that was all the muscles of the transversospinal system, the second layer of the deep back muscles. Now, let's finally do the first layer, which is the most superficial layer just underneath the superficial muscles of the back. The first ones are here. They're called the spinospinal system because they go from the spinous process of the lower vertebrae to the spinous process of the upper vertebrae. Surprisingly enough, these muscles are called spinalis muscles, and they're made up of two muscles. One is in the cervical region, called spinalis cervicis, and they originate from the spinous process of C6 to T2 and insert at the spinous process of C2 to C4. The other one is at the thoracic region, called spinalis thoracis. It originates from the spinous process of T10 to L3 and insert at the spinous process of T1 to T8. So that's this one. Then there's another large muscle that's considered the first layer of the deep back muscles, and they are the spinotransverse system, which are a system of fibers that go from the spinous process of the lower vertebrae to the transverse process of the upper vertebrae, and they're called the longissimus muscles. There are three parts. First, there's the longissimus thoracis, which originates from the dorsal surface of the sacrum, as we see here, the iliac crest, and the spinous process of T11 to L5, and they insert at the transverse process of T1 to T12, as well as the costal angle of the second to the 12th rib, or some sources might say from the third to the 12th rib. These origin and insertion points really differ from source to source. Then there's the longissimus cervicis, this one. It originates from the transverse process of T1 to T6, and inserts at the transverse process of C2 to C5. Then there's the longissimus capitis, which is here in yellow. It originates from the transverse process of C4 to T4 and inserts at the mastoid process. So that's these ones. Then there's a large muscle up here called the splenius muscle, which are divided into two set of muscle fibers. There's the splenius capitis, which originate at the spinous process of C3 to T3, and insert at the mastoid process. Then there's the splenius cervicis, which originate at the spinous process of T3 to T6 and insert at the transverse process of C1 to C2. So that's these ones. The last one is the iliocostal muscle, as you see here. And there are three parts to this muscle based on the location as well. There's the iliocostalis lumborum, which originate at the thoraco-lumbar fascia, the iliac crest and the dorsal sacrum, and then insert at the 6 lower ribs. Then there's the iliocostalis thoracis, which originates at the 6 lower ribs and inserts at the 6 upper ribs. Then there's the iliocostalis cervicis, which originates at the 6 upper ribs and inserts at the transverse processes of C4 to C6. Awesome. So that was all the deep muscles of the back. We've covered the spinospinal system and the spinotransverse system, which are considered a part of the first layer, the most superficial one. We've gone through the transversospinal system, which are considered a part of the second layer, except the short muscle fibers of rotatorius muscle. They're considered a part of the third layer. And we've gone through the suboccipital muscles and the system of short muscles, which are considered the third layer and the deepest muscles we have in the back. And that, my friends, are the deep muscles of the back.